So I'm underway on some of the testing of the circuits. Again, I'll just write things out on a scrap piece of paper before I do it on the actual on the official paperwork. So just run through, I've done some insulation resistance testing, done some earth fault loop impedance testing, not got the results for the lighting circuits just yet. I've got a problem with the lighting circuit, so I haven't done that just yet. As you can see here, on circuit number 9, I've got the cables all out here. This is one of the ring final circuits. Now, initially I went round and I did a ZS test on those on them circuits to work out, just to make sure everything was okay. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 sockets on that ring circuit. Now, I have already tested this, as you can see. I've also done my little R1, R2 and RN end-to-end results. And as you can see, we've got 999 for R1, R2 is 15.6 and RN is 999 again. So we'll just go through them again just to check. So I've got the end-to-end there. And again, it's reading 999 on the machine. Again, it's still reading 999. So we go on to the CPC, and I can hear it clicking. And this time it's 15 or 16.4. I think I recorded 15.6. So straight away, that's showing that this isn't a ring circuit, okay, or somewhere along the line the ring circuit has been broken. So one of the checks I have done then is because maybe this ring circuit and here, which is only controlling two sockets in the kitchen, maybe that is somehow connected. So again, I'm just going to link the line to there. It's saying it's not, so that's sometimes a problem where they've just had two ring circuits and they've linked them to and they've got them round the wrong way. So again, that's not the case, and do the same on the neutral. Now, if you look on the insulation resistance for this circuit, I haven't got a very good insulation resistance. Now, everything is unplugged. I think there's 10 sockets, so everything's been unplugged. And I've also just done a line to earth test on circuit 9 on both legs, because the insulation resistance I was getting when I tested that circuit as a whole was very poor. So we're going to do an insulation resistance test now between one of the legs of the line. We'll turn this to 500 volts and the earth bar. So again, that's reading very low there, 0.09. And if you see there, I've made a recording there on that one. That was 0.06 this time, or that time. We'll go on to the other leg. And the other leg looks absolutely fine. About 341, and before I measured 334. So again, we'd go through all of the circuit through that. So this is now sort of what you'd probably call further investigation. What am I going to do to this? I'm not really sure at the moment. I'm not going to actually do anything just yet. But if you think about it, we've got a 32 amp circuit breaker controlling, in effect, two radial circuits, not a ring circuit. So these are only 2.5 mil cable, so really we need to downgrade this 32 amp to a 20 amp. And I have got a a spare 20 amp Wilex circuit breaker. So that's one of the things I will be doing on this EICR, is I'll just take this 32 amp out and I'll stick the 20 amp in there. At least then I know that the cable is better protected because it's a 20 amp rather than a 32 amp. I think 22.5 mil is only rated at about 25 amps or something like that. So sticking a 20 amp in there will be okay. Apart from that, perhaps I might have to come back and do some further investigation to work out exactly what's what. I could probably come back and split these two circuits into two radial circuits. So have two 20 amp circuit breakers. That would be also a good thing, because at the moment, this circuit breaker here is just controlling two sockets in the kitchen, and then this one is controlling everything else. So if we added another 20 amp circuit onto it, we're then splitting these sockets up to give us a bit more or a little bit better for the customer. Again, if you look up in here in this junction box, one of these cables is connected. This cable here is connected to one leg of the ring. So maybe my fault is up in this junction box, but I'm not going to start taking that apart on an EICR. That could lead into no end of work and take a lot longer. So that would be something I'd come back to do. Just noticing there as well, I don't know if I said before, but there's a broken cable sticking through the ceiling there. Anything like that could be the cause of why that ring circuit isn't reading as a ring. Anyway, we'll crack on and get on with the work.